Welcome to the Climate and Water Outlook for July to September 2015. El Niño continues to strengthen in the Pacific Ocean, which means its impacts are likely to continue right through the year. But the chances of low rainfall don't mean no rain. We've had some good falls in the last couple of weeks. Rain at the right time can make all the difference to winter crops. Let's start with those recent conditions. Good rains in June have brought over 25 millimetres to inland eastern Australia, much of which has fallen in drought-affected areas. For instance, Roma had almost twice its average June rainfall with 53 millimetres in one day. This out-of-season rainfall is the most since January, but welcome as this is, it doesn't break the drought. It only slightly eases the long-term rainfall deficiencies in central Queensland and northern New South Wales. Short-term conditions have actually deteriorated in western Victoria and coastal areas of South Australia. Temperatures in June have reached 1 to 3 degrees above normal across large parts of the north, setting the scene for one of the warmer Junes on record for Australia. In contrast, a cold blast from Antarctica meant snow on the Alps for the start of the 2015 snow season. Unfortunately for the skiers and snowboarders, this cold air was short-lived. Perisher had its warmest June day on record, 14.3 degrees on the 12th. Now let's see what may drive Australia's climate in the coming months. El Niño is underway. All of the models we survey predict Pacific Ocean temperatures will remain above El Niño levels at least until the end of the year. As we progress through winter, typical El Niño features are drier conditions across eastern Australia and warmer days in the south. As a result, average inflows into major water storages in southeastern Australia are usually 30 to 40% lower in El Niño years. We'll keep an eye on water storage levels in the Murray-Darling Basin, which are now 13% lower than in June last year. Another important climate driver for Australia is the Indian Ocean. Currently, the Indian Ocean as a whole is warmer than average, raising the odds of rainfall in parts of Australia. However, about half the models we survey predict sea surface temperatures will cool to our northwest, while waters near the Horn of Africa become warmer. That pattern, called a positive Indian Ocean dipole, typically sees less moisture flow across Australia and higher pressures over the southeast. This can exacerbate El Niño impacts. So what is our rainfall outlook for July to September? The warmer Indian Ocean continues to raise the odds of above average rainfall in the west, as it has for much of the year. The east is likely to be average to drier than average, as might be expected during El Niño. Our rainfall outlook has moderate accuracy at this time of year. And what can we expect from streamflows? Our outlooks have eased a little in the southeast as water from the east coast low rains in April and May flows out of the system. Outlooks to the end of August indicate low flows at 28 of 86 locations. Near median flows are forecast at 32 locations, and high flows are more likely at 26. Accuracy for our streamflow forecast is moderate at this time of year. Now turning to temperature. Odds still favour warmer than average days across most of Australia due to clearer skies and drier soils. Accuracy for this outlook is moderate to high at this time of year. Nights are also likely to be warmer than average in most areas. So in summary, El Niño continues to strengthen and is likely to be with us until at least year's end. July to September is likely to be wetter than average in the west of Australia and average to drier than average in the east. Streamflow outlooks are mixed, but inflows typically reduce during El Niño. For more details, head to our website at bomb.gov.au/climate/ahead. You can also follow us on Facebook and Twitter. Our next video will be released on Thursday, the 30th of July. For the Bureau of Meteorology, I'm Paul Fakemer.